Okay, with this side, I'm just hoping to capture the darkness of the solution all the way from the other side. I guess you can see some light bouncing off the bottom. But the solution itself doesn't really even transmit much light all the way through across one with the one coffee pot. This guy's been running for 24 hours. I wanted to see what my voltage across here is so far. And it looks like we still got holding at 2 volts. I'm gonna shut everything down here. Have corrosion almost everywhere already. That wire started to corrode already. This guy looks like, I don't know what the deal is with this, if the chlorine gas just, you know, like, took off the tin coating of that. Didn't do it over here so much. It's kind of a weird corrosion pattern there on that one. It's kind of different. I see the wires corroded, probably from the chlorine gas that's being emitted here. Here's the copper plate. It does look like we grew some copper. It's rough. It's not. Didn't produce a smooth coat. On the back side, I think it's kind of interesting that there's much less copper deposited. Looks almost like maybe even there's some other metals have deposited on the back side. That may be the nickel or something. So this is where, you know, like having an agitator in the solution may be helpful. Of course, notice I'm doing this in an area where I can contain all this stuff. I'm not losing anything. So I know exactly what all I'm getting. Don't want to be losing stuff. It definitely seems to have deposited a different metal near the bottom. I think it's kind of cool that this is zinc or tin or what that is down the bottom, but that'd be kind of cool if we could exploit that someday and actually intentionally do that. The solution itself is still pretty dark. Okay, shining the camera through the light, it does seem that the solution is clearing up a little bit, at least near the surface. Seems like it gets pretty cloudy as you go down. So I'm fixing to filter it and see if there's any kind of precipitate in here, what's going on. So I've got it dried off with paper napkins and everything like that, and it now weighs 108.86 grams. I'm sure this process can be refined, but you do see that that is pretty good clean copper there. The backside is fairly smooth, at the bottom it's fairly smooth, or near the midway. At the top, looks like we had a higher charge density and just the faster rate of deposition of copper. It started getting kind of rough. Pull my plate out. There's the copper plate. Looks like we're still accumulating some metal. So after 60 hours total, approximately, we are at 118.72 grams, but just some observations about electroplating. Start looking up here close on the edge. We get a lot of this copper along this edge. It'll flake off. It's spiky. It's not attached as a smooth sheet. At the bottom of the backside, it's got, we get intermittent layers of some sort of other metal, which actually is not plated on very firmly. It rubbed off with the paper napkin. I see some kind of more coppery kind of bronze underneath. Above that zone, in the middle of this thing, on the backside, we got some real nice deposition of copper. Came out nice and smooth. It's attached firmly. Doesn't scrape off, so it's like a good saleable sheet here of copper. You know, if it all came out like it did right here, you could take it straight to the scrapyard. Have to worry about melting it down or anything. Today I notice is the concentration, you know, I'm assuming the concentration of copper is like diminishing in that bath. So I think the rate of electroplating is down. Looks like we gained maybe 10 more grams. Not as much, and it was a longer period of time. So the rate has slowed, and that has seemed to help coat a smoother layer, even on the front side. The only place it's kind of rough is over here on the edges of the front, and then the very edges of the metal. So as I redesign the cathode here, I'm going to take some of these observations into account to build a better thing to deposit my copper on. It does look like, you know, one thing, maybe you could go with a lower voltage at the beginning, but also I'm going to maybe look into using a physical barrier to slow the rate of, you know, plating of copper, just slow the rate down a little bit. Maybe I can get it to come out a little smoother. Probably definitely put something on the edges to keep any plating at all from happening on the edges. Encase it in wax or plastic or something like that. Okay, so I weighed those little shavings that I scraped off the other morning, and it was 2.31 grams of copper. There's gonna be some tin, zinc, other metals mixed in there too, but overall the final weight, 121.03 minus the 93.52 starting weight led us to 27.51 grams of mostly copper after 60 hours of electrolysis at approximately 2 volts.